Hello there and welcome to Alton Park here in Cheshire for the opening two rounds of the British GT Championship. It's a great start to the year with bigger grids and a fantastic selection of sports cars in what is still the UK's most prestigious GT racing competition. The series will be fought over 13 races at 7 different circuits around the UK, as well as a trip to the spiritual home of sports car racing, Spa-Francorchamps in Belgium. This is going to be a tough season for all the drivers involved. So before battle commences out there on track, let's take a look at some of this year's runners and riders. There's a whole host of Ferraris in the field this season, and they all look quick. Adam Wilcox and Phil Burton will be hoping for better reliability in 2010, while Hector Lester and Alan Simonson are always fast out there on track. The M-Tech Ferrari of Duncan Cameron and Matt Griffin also struggled with reliability, but by the end of the season they had turned the car into a race winner and will be hoping that they can carry that form into the new season and give them a chance of taking the crown.
You know, it's always good as a professional. You want to be competing against the best guys all the time, and British GT is a fantastic series. You know, it's one of the best series in the world, and obviously we've got a lot of top-line drivers here this year, more than last year, so, you know, it's definitely a lot tougher, but as far as I'm concerned, the more the merrier, really.
The Jones brothers return in their Ascari to defend their title, making them the team everyone else really wants to beat.
We had a good season last year and we've updated the car a bit for this year, so hopefully we can stay with the Ferraris at the front.
The Porsche of David Ashburn returns to the championship, adding to the vast array of machinery out there. There is also another addition to the 2010 grid, the Audi R8s of the United Autosports team look awesome and should be impressive when they get out on track.
I've never raced at Alton Park, but I've tested at Alton Park. Of course, my teammate has the track record around here, so I'm going to have him do the heavy lifting for us. Fantastic track, probably one of the best you could race at, but you don't want to go off.
The G4 class should see some great action between cars like the wonderful open-top KTM Crossbow and the Lotus 211, as well as the ever-competitive Ginetta G50s. Danish driver Viva Schmed has moved over from single-seaters to race in this class and will be hoping to get to grips with the change as quickly as she can.
It's very different driving style. Single-seater is really, really aggression and you know, you have a lot more aerodynamics and you don't really have that in these cars.
So it's the defending champions, the Jones brothers, that take the first pole position of the year. They'll be looking to start as they mean to go on, and it'll be hectic into that first corner. Here's our commentator, Martin Haven.
So here we go then, the 2010 British GT season gets underway at its now traditional opener at Alton Park. First race will be the usual format, 1 hour driver change race. That means around 36 laps, barring major incident. It's going to be pretty chilly as well. Track temperatures are low, so is the air temperature, just around 8 degrees. That might lead to a few first lap nerves. On board with Duncan Cameron, alongside us the pole sitter David Jones. Cars number 1 and 2 in this year's field, defending champions on pole as we get the green light, first time of asking. And it's going to be really interesting to see how those two Audi R8s perform right behind. They've been very quick in German hands in 2009. Let's see what they can do around the ultra-tight confines of Alton Park. On board then with David Ashburn, Porsche returning to the series. He's already moved up into fourth place, splitting those two United Autosport Audis. And of course, not just the front-running GT3s, we've got the G4 cars as well. The Crossbows, the Lotuses, the Nissan, all challenging the Ginettas that dominated last year in the class. So sweeping through Island Bend, down to the Shell Oil's hairpin, down the inside comes Juan Jarez, the Argentine driver in that dark blue Ferrari. He dived by Mike Gash there for sixth position. And David Jones trying to stretch the lead immediately, but very cautious in these cold conditions on still relatively cold tyres. They come out of the tyre warmers nice and hot, but then 5 minutes sitting on the grid puts an end to that in these Arctic temperatures. Battle for third place. Zach Brown in Audi number 23 with the red highlights on the bonnet. The other car has got the blue. Right behind him, David Ashburn, easy to spot with a lime green. More green highlights on the Aston. That's Paul White, sharing with Michael Bentwood. In front is the black Ferrari 430 of Phil Burton, fully updated for the new season with a neat matte black paint job as well, looking very mean. They're hoping change of look, change of aero packages and updates will give them a little bit better speed and a bit better luck. MTech in second, United Autosports in third, but it's still the Joneses leading in the Ascari. New look on the 21 Chad Racing Ferrari. Chris Hyman starts that one. He shares with Dan Brown in STP colours. Should have number 43 on it, perhaps, but that doesn't work with the numbering system here. STP 43, Richard Petty. There is David Ashburn, fourth place, and he's looming large in the mirrors of Zach Brown. Zach, as he was saying earlier, not used to Alton Park, and as he said, which everybody understands, I think, here, it's not a track you want to have an accident on. There are runoff areas. You just cover them very quickly, particularly here when it's wet. If you go off an island, the barriers are right there. And he's under pressure now again from Juan Gariz. Little lock-up there from the Argentine, but that's neat racing in that dark blue Ferrari. Managed to avoid clattering into the back of the Porsche of David Ashburn. He's got Mike Gatch right behind him with the blue bonnet highlights. And here in G4 class, good battle for third place. That's the Nissan of Rick Pearson ahead of the Crossbow of Benjamin Harvey. All over Hilltop, David Ashburn with the Porsche making a move for third, and he squeezes around Zach Brown's nose. Understandably, Brown perhaps not quite pushing as hard as Ashburn is. David, of course, has raced here numerous times. Zach Brown feeling a little hemmed in. Brand new machinery, of course. It's still unraced up to this stage in the team's hands. Mike Gatch in the second Audi, muscling around behind Gariz, sense the Ferrari will get away. And here again is that G4 battle, Pearson and Harvey in the KTM Crossbow. 15th and 16th overall, and Zach Brown having a little moment there. Juan Gariz taking advantage, slotting straight down the inside. He goes up to fourth place. The Audi's now running in fifth and sixth positions. Does look to me, with a couple of spots of water on the camera lens, as if Zach Brown is struggling a fraction more than Mike Gatch. Gatch in the 22, looking to try and make a move past. So too the Chad Racing Ferrari of Chris Hyman, that red and pale blue STP coloured car. Battle for 12th place here. In front, Phil Driver in the GT Cup Porsche with the green back to its numbers, just ahead of Jamie Stanley in his G4 class Ginetta. As David Jones looks pretty comfortable out front, concentrating on the action a little further back. Still, Zach Brown ahead of Mike Gatch in the two United Autosport Audis. Great to see these cars racing in the British Championship. So far, only raced in Germany in the VLN, the long-distance races on the old Nordschleife of the Nürburgring. On board again with Zach Brown, a little bit of squeal from the carbon brakes as he gets into Knickerbrook. Again, one of the things that these cars are going to have to be adapted for by the team is the bumpy nature of most British tracks. Of course, the Nürburgring is very bumpy as well, but it's a very different track. Much longer, much faster, and a huge looping spin for Juan Gariz as he gets it run on the exit of Druids. Lots of steam from the tyres on the wet grass. He rejoins, but he's going to lose a lot of ground. He was in fourth, and he will come out in front of the battle for 10th place. Phil Burton right behind him. So all these three Ferraris will now battle on. Let's take a look then from Zach Brown's viewpoint. Oh, wheel on the exit, over on the dirt. Woof, around he went. Scary stuff, but he's okay.